is the energy vibration lazing for the Stenbock Sun, for the Capricorn Sun Moon arising. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. I want to say thank you to each and every person for supporting my channel. And I'm asking each and every person to give your feedbacks on the channel, okay? It is the third week, and the week begins from the 15th until the 21st. It is going to be a week of working out situations with the water sign people and the earth sign people. It is a wonderful week for you guys. It's absolutely a wonderful week. Whatever is happening, it's going to be a good week, even though the energy of the Three of Pentacles is you working on something. You are trying to make something good in your life. Whatever it is, you're trying to make a positive change in your life. And you have a situation that you have to deal with the Princess of Pentacles, whoever this Princess of Pentacles is for some of you. This could be yourself, and some of you have to deal with stuff to do with the Queen of Water, okay? So what is happening is that this week is the energy of an earth sun, and it is balance, and you guys have the energy of judgment in reverse. You have the energy of judgment in reverse. It could be that message that was supposed to come through isn't coming through. It can be that whatever the judgment is, you are going to see things very, very clearly in this week, because there's a transformation that is coming up, and you're going to see things very clearly in this week, okay? So when the judgment comes in reverse, there is as if the message, you have seen the message, like you have seen the message, and you know exactly what is going on. So let's look and see what exactly is transpiring for you Capricorns, okay? Let's see what is going on for you Capricorns. Okay, before I go any further, we are going to look. Monday is a good day because you're connecting with people. Some of you are going to start a new job on Monday. This is a wonderful situation for some of you. This is going to be good. Whatever the situation is, it's going to be a positive one. Some of you are starting a Monday, and it's going to be positive. Some of you are working together, people who are studying, who are connecting to other people in study groups. On Tuesday, you have the energy for you ladies between the ages of 25 and 45. You have there's happiness that is coming in, and there's an energy of the King of Wands in the reverse form, which is good. This is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. So some of you princess has a situation that you are dealing with this man, and now on Tuesday, finally, he cannot affect you anymore. The crowning of your week is the Four of Wands. The Four of Wands is wonderful. The Four of Wands is your home, your work, and it's for some of you, it's you're standing firm ground, and you have a strong stability against your enemies, because you can see them growling at you, and you have a strong stability against your enemies. On Thursday, you have a situation with the Queen of and this is a Pisces, a Cancer, or a Scorpion. So you have a situation with her on Thursday. On Friday, there is really an end, a debt and transition, and that is coming up, a real debt and transmission of something that is coming up, but it's bringing forth happiness. Okay, so this working together and this transformation is happening between the ladies who are between the ages of 25 and 45, okay? This is happiness is going to be what's happening, because you're connecting with a group. You're going to be working with them. There is a transformation of new things and wonderful things is coming up. You have the Nine of Cups, so your wishes and dreams are going to come out for you, Tauruses. Your wishes and for you, ladies who are between the ages of 25 and 45, okay? So this is good because whatever that has transpired in your love life, something new is coming up. Okay, as we move between Thursday, Wednesday, to see what is transpiring for some people, some of you ladies who had a situation with a man over the age of 40 that was an Leo and Aries Leo or a Sagittarian, whatever the burden was, it's now come to an end. He is in the reverse form and the burdens have come to an end, and you have a strong stability. You have a strong stability over this person, whatever your burdens and whoever this person was and whatever he was costing you in your life. He is now in the reverse, and the Ten of Wands is also in the reverse form, which is extremely good. As we move on, some of you are having a situation or was having a situation with this woman who is and Pisces, a Cancer, or a Scorpion. Some of you were having a situation with this woman, and finally you're seeing the truth of the situation. Your enemies are trying to reach you, but it's hard for them to reach you because you have totally it's as if you're totally closed off yourself to certain situation and certain energies around you. So whatever your enemies were trying to do, what is happening now is that you have a strong foundation against this woman who is a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion. You have a strong foundation against her. And whoever your enemies are, you're now seeing them. And it's as if the universe is putting you so high so that they can't reach you. Let's see what else is happening, because there seems to be the High Priestess comes up on Monday, which is good. That is going to do some help. Ten of Swords is in reverse, which is good. Money, there is going to be a transition with your money accomplishment. The Nine of Pentacles and the Nine of Cup is going to be good. Whoever was the king of success is going to come into you. Okay, success is going to be coming into you. So this is good. This is actually very wonderful and very good. What I'm receiving is that there was a lot of people who have been dishonestly people were working against them, and this happened because some people begin with a lie, and the person who begin with this lie is either an Aries, a Leo, or a Sagittarius. This person begin with a lie and has cost a lot of you Capricorns some problems, some undeserving problems. And this person has been like, he has been paying off people to disrupt your life, and he has lied, and the truth has come out, because you can see with this energy of the Ten of Swords in the reverse form, this energy of the Ten of Swords is in reverse form, because you have a strong foundation over the lies that this man has told. Okay, because what I'm seeing here for the ladies between the ages of 25 and 45, you have the energy of a Six of Cups. So whatever that has transpired is as if the angels and guides is going to bring someone in your life. They're going to bring back happiness and joy and love in your life. Okay, so whatever the situation was for you ladies between the ages of 25 and 45, your psychic is going to be very high on Monday. You're going to be working with people that your psychic is extremely high. It's as if your guiding angels are there guiding you, and they are guiding you up the part that is going to bring you wonderful happiness and joy. There is going to be a transformation. So what is happening is that if you had felt a failure, if you had felt a failure in something in your life, there is a transformation coming in. And this is why the energy of the Judgment is in reverse for you guys, because what it is saying is that, look, the angels and guides saw what has taken place. You felt as if it was a failure whatever that was happening to you, as if you felt as if you were a failure. You're not a failure. So the judgment is not in the upright position, because it's telling you it's not you. It has nothing to do with you. It has to do with this man who has been very, 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 this person is a sick person. This person carries a very low energies, because whatever he has done, he has tried to make your life hell, okay? And it's not, for some of you, it is an ex-partner. For some of you, it's an ex-business partner. For some of you, it's an ex-colleague. And whatever has transpired, the 10 of one is in reverse, which is good. The burdens are now in reverse. The burdens that you are carrying are now in the reverse form, and you end up with a 9 of pentacles. Okay, so whatever that has transpired, whatever the situation was, that this man has caused you, okay? This man can be an Aries, a Leo, or a Cancer. Whatever that this man has caused you, this man is someone from a fork of life. This man is someone from out your past. This man is someone who you have known in lifetime before that came back and, you know, try to kill your happiness and joy. The energy of the 9 of pentacles is here because whatever he has done to you, there's the exchange of money that is coming to heal the situation. As we look at this energy with this Queen of Cups, if you have someone in your life that is a Queen of Cups, the Queen of Cups is a Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpion. This lady is not really someone who is very nice. You have to, and not all of them, because I know there are very nice ones, but there is this person, you know, you're seeing the truth of who she is. It's not a very nice person. You know, they're trying to come at you, but it's as if your angels and guides put you up, because this is you with your angels and guides protecting you, okay? And there, you know, look at the crab. You know, is trying to reach you, and it's as if your spirit guides and angels are protecting you, and you're seeing a situation for what it is. Whatever your financial situation is, it's going to be changing. Whatever your financial situation is, it's going to be changing, and it's going to be change for the 9 of pentacles. So this is wonderful. So you have not to worry about whatever is transpiring in your life, because it's going to be changing to the 9 of pentacles, because she tried also to block you from receiving anything. This is the energy of an older man, an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. This is the energy of an older man, an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. Whatever that has transpired with this man, he was an enemy. He was someone who was trying to break you down together with this King of Wands. And these two, it's as if this one told this one a lot of lies, and this one go together because of money. And you know, you people will be amazed the thing that people will do for money. I am just realizing I will never ever ever sell out anyone for money, never. And I have seen this happening so much, and I'm wondering, and I'm saying, oh my God, people are really, really sick. And people are really, really sick. But, you know, as I see what is going on here, whatever that has transpired, whatever that has happened, that has caused you unhappiness, the happiness is coming back. The happiness is coming back. And this King of Wands is in the reverse, and your enemies can't reach you anymore. They can't reach you anymore. Your enemies can't reach you anymore. And you're stepping back from a lot of things in your life. Your financial situation is going to be balanced out. So if you're having, you're worried about your financial situation, you need not to worry about anything. Whoever has a situation to deal with, the King of Swords, this person is now out of your life, because obviously this person was trying to use the Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups is really not a nice person. Success is yours. You have a good, stable foundation, and success is going to be yours in this week. Okay, let's move on and let's look at the wisdom of the House of Knights to see what they have to say for you, Capricorns. Let go. This is a perfect reading of let go. Oh my gosh, thanks. A perfect, perfect reading of let go. Let go and let God. I'm not sure if a lot of you know this thing. Let go and let God, as you are on, and it's the number 22. Okay, let's see your number. The number 9 is very, very vocal. Number 9, number 10. Number 9 and number 10 and number 4. 4, 9, and 10. Very important, people. 4, 9, and 10. Very important. And now you have the 22, which is saying let go. So we want to see what it's a week of release. So to remind you that freedom is important to everyone. If you love something, set it free. Don't hold on to it tight, lest you chase it away. You have the freedom at this time to choose whatever you want. Let others do the same. You will be happy you did. Miracles come when you let go and allow the magic to happen of its own accord. Okay, so whatever is happening, let go of the situation, because you have a strong foundation, because whatever you're looking for, work, it's going to happen for you this week. Success is going to happen for you this week. A new house, a new apartment, it's going to happen for you this week. But you have to let go of the whole, let go of the situation that has transpired in your life. Let go of the people who have caused you harm and hurt. And these people are the Pisces. I said Pisces, but it is an older woman who is a Pisces, a Cancer, or a Scorpion. It's an older man that is Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, and it's an older man that is the King of Swords, which is an Aquarius, a Libra, or a Sagittarius. Okay, all these people, let go of them. Okay, let's move forward and see what is the next energy. Hasta la vista, baby. Okay, all right. I don't know, my angels and guides have been doing this lately. Okay. So, let go, hasta la vista, baby. Okay, so this is what they're saying. Let go and say hasta la vista, baby. Because obviously there are things that you need to let go of, and people and situation that you need to let go of. And you are saying in this week, hasta la vista. Remember the song Queen Esla sing in the Disney movie Freeze, when she unleashed her magic. That's you. Well, if you didn't catch this action flick, it's time to let go. Walk away. And just like you never look back at the trash that you leave at the crown of the road, don't give it a second glance. It's time for new beginnings. Out with the old and in with the new. I want to say to each and every person, namaste, until next week.